Alright, so this is the experimental setup or instrument which you will be using to measure the ionizing potential of xenon. So this is your the pentode which I mentioned to you. The various pins of the pentode are connected to these terminals, so you can see them. This is basically, this first knob out here is basically connected to the K, plate K, which I told you is the cathode. Then this one, the second knob, is connected to grid 2, which is basically this one. This terminal is basically connected to grid 1. You can see that it is coming here. So this is K, this is grid 1, this is grid 2, and this is plate. So, which is actually marked as A here. Some student has actually tried to make it as P. A is nothing but the P plate in your diagram. So, I will now demonstrate how to make the connections in an easy way. For that, let me just pause the video for a minute. Usually when I make the connections, I will start with the grids. Okay? So the first thing, if you remember, you know that the plate P and grid 2 are shorted. They are connected together. So I will make that connection first. And from the plate, it will go to the positive of the micrometer, which is used to measure the plate current. So what I do is I connect from point A, you can make the connection like this. It will go to the positive of the micrometer, which is basically here. You can see the micrometer. And from the negative of the micrometer, it will go to the negative of the voltmeter, which measures the plate voltage. So this voltmeter is basically the plate measuring thing. So I connect it to the negative of the plate voltmeter, and from the positive of the plate voltmeter, which is basically this terminal, it goes to the cathode K, which is way down here. We will not be able to see it right now at the end of it. So this black terminal which I connected here is basically for the cathode. Now what I do is, I will start connecting from the grid 1. Grid 1 is basically shown here. So I take the grid 1, you can see the grid 1 here, this is the grid 1. From the grid 1, it will go to a resistance box. The resistance box is kept somewhere here, which you are not able to see it now. Let me just turn the camera towards the resistance box so you can see the resistance box. So I will connect it to the resistance box, come into the resistance box, and from the other side of the resistance box I will connect a wire the positive of the grid voltmeter. So this is basically the grid voltmeter. So let me just bring it back. So you can see that this is the grid voltmeter. The positive of the grid voltmeter is here. So I connect from the other side of the resistance box, the wire, to the positive of the grid voltmeter. And from the negative of the grid voltmeter, which is basically this, it will go back to the K. K is basically the cathode. Okay? So I connected that part also. I don't know whether you can make it out. Yeah. Just adjust the camera a bit more. So you can see that I have connected from the positive of this thing sorry, negative of the grid voltmeter, it comes to the cathode, which is here. Okay, so that basically completes our circuitry. Now, before you do anything else, from the resistance box, you take out 2000 ohms pin, which I shall do now. So I have taken the 2000 volt pin. Okay. And then I made sure that all the other pins are tightly fixed in. Okay. That's what I'm doing right now, which I don't have to show it to you. This is a standard instruction which shall be given to all of you. Okay. Now, what you have to do is, first thing what you have to do is, connect the apparatus to the power supply. After that, before you begin anything, make sure that the VAK knob is turned to the minimum. Same way, the plate voltage VG is also turned to the minimum. And once you have done that, you can turn on the mains. So once you turn on the mains, you will see that this particular light will start glowing. So you can see it here. This is glowing. And then what you have to do is you have to set the plate voltage. And every apparatus has got its own plate voltage, unfortunately here. So out here it's written the value of the plate voltage which you have to set is basically 0.75 volts. Okay. So what you have to do is you will turn this particular knob which is hidden behind all these wires. And turn it so that the plate voltage comes to 0.75 voltage. So you can see this needle slowly moving, and this needle should come to 0.75 volt, which I set it right now. Okay, and after that, what you do is this voltage value is kept constant. We are not going to alter it anymore. So don't touch this particular knob, which is out here. You just make sure that this is kept at 0.75 volt. Okay. And when you read the readings, please make sure that you are looking at the needle vertically downward without any parallax on the mirror. Okay. Now, what you do is you slowly turn this particular knob. When you turn this particular knob, you will see that this value changes, but the micrometer reading will not change, okay, for some time. So you will slowly increase in the voltage. You can see that this voltmeter is started to show the deflection, but your ammeter is still showing you, micrometer is still showing you zero. So you keep on increasing it. At one particular value, which will be somewhere here, somewhere here, you can see that the micrometer starts showing you readings. Okay, so if you keep on increasing this voltage still further, you will see that the micrometer value suddenly shoots up. You can see that it is keeping on increasing, whereas this voltage is remaining a constant. Notice that also. Okay, so I am reducing the voltage now of the plate voltage. So in your experiment, what you have to do is, first the resistance box, you will have 2000 ohms unplugged, then you keep on turning the VG and note down what is the corresponding plate current. Okay? That is being tabulated, and then once the readings are taken completely, you change the resistance box resistance to 3000 ohms. Again, repeat the experiment once again, and a third time by keeping the resistance box resistance at 4000 ohms. Okay. So once you get these particular readings, whose tabular column values are shown here, you can try to show it to you. So you can see it here. What you have to do is basically the grid potential value is tabulated here. For resistance value corresponding to 2000 ohms, you note down what is the plate current in microammeter. That value is tabulated here. R2, then what you do is when the resistance value is kept at 3000 ohms, again note down what is the plate current. Then when the the resistance value is kept at 4000, again you note down what is the plate current. Finally, what you're going to do is you're going to plot this particular graph of plate current versus the grid voltage on the x-axis. So you will get data points which for R1 is equal to 200, so the 2000 ohms, you'll get data points which might look like this for you. You draw a straight line through them and it will intersect the x-axis at one point. Same way for R2, you plot another set of data points. Okay. Let's say the data points are coming through them. The best fit straight line through that will also intersect at exactly at the same point. And then for this one also, you plot the same values, you will get the same point. So identify how much is this voltage. That will be equal to the stopping potential of, ionizing potential of the xenon gas. So that is your experiment. I hope you will do